Hello everybody, welcome to this instruction video. In this video I'd like to show you how to make this square. This square is called Denna and it's been designed by Polly Plum. The yarn that I'm using to make this square is Scheepje stonewashed yarn. I'm using it in various colors in combination with a 3.5mm crochet hook. I'll take you step by step through the rows that make up this pattern, and I just really like the intricate design that you have here. This row here as opposed to the circle here. So I really like this square. I'll take you step by step through the rows that make up this pattern. Thank you for watching. I hope it's a useful video for you. Round one, I'm going to make a magic ring. It's my yarn tail. Over, I'm going to go underneath, grab that loop, and then come back, grab it again, and pull through. This is my magic ring. Now to start round one. Chain one. This is not a stitch, it's just to get you to the correct working height. In the magic ring, single crochet, and chain three. One, two, to do that four times. So that was once, and again twice, a single crochet in the ring, and then one, two, three. Again, single crochet in the ring, one, two, three. I've now done one, two, I've got done the repeat three times, and number four, single crochet in the ring, and then one, two, three chain stitches. I'm going to close the ring, so I'm going to pull this loop here. Just pull my yarn tail. So close the ring. Yeah. And then on the first single crochet, so you see there's the chain one, you don't need that one. On that single crochet, close there with a slip stitch. That's all just still a little fiddly, but when your square gets bigger, this will be much easier. Then that completes round one. And at this point I'm still going to leave my yarn tail. Only when it's a little bigger I'm going to work it away. That completes round one. You've got four of these loops. I'm going to be working in those in the next round. Round two. Start by slip stitching into the next chain three space. You can see that space there. You're going to slip stitch into that space. Chain three, this counts as your first double crochet. Then in the same space, work the rest of a shell. So that's two more double crochets. It's one and there we go, two. So that's three double crochets basically with the first chain three there, so three double crochets, chain two, and then three more doubles in the same space. That's one, two, get more yarn, and three. This is your first shell worked. Chain one, remember this chain one, it's easy to forget. Now we're going to move on to the next chain three space, so that chain three space there, and work a shell in that also. So that's going to be three doubles, one, two, three doubles, chain two, and three more doubles in the same space. It's one, two, and three. That's another shell made. Again, chain one. Now we're going to do exactly the same on the next petal here, this this chain 3 space, going to work another shell in there, chain 1, and then work another shell in here. It's going to work 2 more shells, and then I'll just see you for the last bit also. Just work the last shell, so in that chain 3 space, 3 doubles, chain 2, 3 doubles. At this point you need a chain 1, so remember this chain 1. And then on this first double crochet, so that's the chain 3, on the top of that chain 3, close there with a slip stitch. At this point I'm going to cut my yarn because I want to use a new color in the next round. And then, so pull, open up, pull through, and then I'll see you for round 3. Round 3, I have a slip knot on my hook. And you're going to start in any chain 1 space, so that's going to be the space here between the shells. You're going to start in any one of those spaces. To start in there with a standing double crochet. So I'm going to go yarn over on my hook and just hold on to that. And then in that chain 1 space, work a double crochet. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and then work another double crochet in the same chain 1 space. That's your first, this is kind of a V stitch that you've worked there. Going to go move onto the chain 2 space that's in your shell. So you see that chain 2 space, going to work a new shell in there. So that means it's going to be 3 doubles. 1, 2, 3 double crochets, chain 2, 1, 2, and then work 3 more doubles in the same space. 1, 2, and 3. And this you're going to repeat all the way around. So this V stitch and then the shell. So now I'm going to work a V stitch and here I'm going to work a new shell. And a V stitch, shell, V stitch, shell. Show you the repeat once more. In the next chain 1 space, here, work a double crochet, chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and then in the same space another double crochet. Go to the chain 2 space and work a shell. To be 3 doubles, 1, 2, 3 doubles, chain 2, and 3 more doubles. So 1, 2, 3. Now you've done the repeat 2 times. Going to now do a 3rd time and a 4th time. Make a jump in the video. And here for the last point, when I've worked this last shell, I'll just show you how to close on that first standing stitch. So now work another V in this chain 1. There's a double, chain 3 and a double. Move on to the chain 2. Work a shell in here. So it's 3 doubles, chain 2 and 3 doubles. Repeat, and I'll see you here when I've done the last shell. I've done the repeats, and now I need to close on the first standing stitch with a slip stitch. Here you see the standing stitch. If I just pull that up, you see that little V hole there. That's where you want to close with a slip stitch. I'm just going to insert my hook in there and close with a slip stitch. I'm going to cut my yarn, bind off, because in the next round I want to use a new color. If you don't want to do that, you can also slip stitch into the next space here. So if you want to use the same color, you slip stitch and you take it from there. I'm going to use a different color, so I'm not going to do this. I'm going to cut my yarn, open up, and then work away my yarn tails. Round 4, I have a new color yarn on my hook with the slip knot. I'm going to start in any chain 3 space. I'm going to choose this one. Start in there with a standing double crochet. Yarn over. Then in the first one, in that first chain 3 space, I'm going to make a standing double crochet. You can also choose this space, that one, or that one. This is the first of 7 double crochets. So that's one, so I'm now going to work 6 more. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now you should have 7 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh no, I made a mistake. 7. You need to have 7 double crochets here. That's important. 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, now it's correct. 7 double crochets in the chain 3 space, the first of which is a standing stitch. Chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're now going to skip this shell and move over to the next chain 3 space. That's that one there, between these two single double crochets. So, yeah, double crochet and double crochet. So in that chain 3 space, I'm going to work 7 more double crochets. And because this is the place where I started the previous round, I've got these yarn tails. I'm actually going to work over them, so securing them to this chain 3 space with those 7 double crochets. So skipping this entire shell, go to the chain 3 space. And that's the first of 7, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This one you can just nip to the back because you're going to be securing it in the next round, but you don't want this to be in front when you work your next round. So if you do it to the back, you can't accidentally make a mistake in the next round. You're going to repeat this all the way around. So that's again chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Skipping the shell in your next chain 3 space. Work again 7 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And this point is again exactly the same as that point. So again, chain 6, work 7 double crochets in the last chain 3 space, chain 6, and then close on your first standing double crochet. I'm going to again change colors, so I'm going to cut my yarn. Round 5, new color yarn on my hook. I'm going to start in the first of 7 double crochets, so you can start there, or on that point, or on this point, doesn't matter. Choose this point to insert. You can start in the first stitch, so opening it up, you see that stitch there. Start with a standing single crochet. Now we work a single on all the other stitches also, so that's going to be 6 more. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. It means you've now worked 7 single crochets. We're now going to come down and work a front post treble around this double crochet from 2 rows down. So around from row 3 to work a front post treble around that stitch. So that means we're going to go twice over for the treble and just fold your work a little bit to really get around that stitch from right to left, back to front, pick up your yarn and then complete the treble. This front post treble, going to do it also on the other side, very easy to forget. Remember these front post trebles. We're going to move on to the next shell. So here the shell from round 3, the chain 4 space from round 4. We're going to connect these two together. We're going to work in the chain 2 space from round 3, so that space there from the shell. We're going to make a new shell in there. And while we do that, we also work over the chain 6 space here to the back. Kind of going to bring them both together and then work a shell. So that's yarn over for a double. Then through the chain 2 space and the chain 6 with the chain 6 to the back. Hook up and work the first double. And this is the first double of 3. So that's 1, 2, 3 doubles. Sorry, my yarn is just a little knotted here. Chain 2. 1, 2. I'm going to move this up because I need to make 3 more doubles in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3. Now you've made a new shell in the old shell and you've connected the chain 6 space here to the back. So everything is secure. You should not have any chain spaces dangling at this point. I'm going to move over to the next series of double crochets. Okay, first going to work a front post treble around the first leg here. From that V stitch we did in row 3. So we're going to work a front post treble around that stitch. Twice over. Again, right to left, back to front, pick up, and complete the treble. Now going to work a single crochets in all 7 of these double crochets. So in the first one you might just have to slightly bend your work back to get into that first stitch. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this stitch here, exactly the same as this last single crochet work there. That means everything that you've done, you're going to repeat this all the way around. And after you've worked this last shell, there you're going to close with a slip stitch on your first standing single crochet. Just show you the repeat once more. First, work a front post treble around the stitch from row 3. Important, remember these front post trebles, they are surprisingly easy to forget. I know this from experience. We now work a shell in the chain 2 space and over the chain 6, having that to the back. It's 1, 2, 3 double crochets, chain 2. And then 3 more doubles in the same space. 1, 2, 3. another shell. Now, again, remember a front post treble. Twice over. And a front post treble. Remember these front post trebles. Followed by 7 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now you're again at the same point we were just a moment ago. Continue this repeat, go all the way around. After you've done your last shell here, close on your first single crochet. And remember, very important, the shell and then the front post treble. You see, I almost forgot the shell. That last front post treble, remember, can't say that often enough. The front post treble and then close on your single crochet. Round 6. A new color yarn on my hook, and we're going to start in the single crochets. You have these 7 single crochets. We're going to start in the first one of those. Doesn't matter if you start here or here, doesn't matter. We're going to start in this one and start in the first one with a standing double crochet. That's the treble. And that's the single, so you're going for that first single crochet. And make a standing double. In the same stitch, make another double. So you've got 2 doubles in the first stitch. 1 double in the next. Two doubles, so 1, 2, and in the following stitch, 1 double. 2 doubles, 1, 2, and 1 double. 2 doubles on the last single crochet. 1, 2. If you're wondering what's the logic here, you've got 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. That will help you to remember how many stitches to work in which. So you can see the rhythm there. 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Chain 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 6, 6 chain stitches. I'm going to skip the shell and then move over to the next 7 single crochets. And there you're going to work the same double combinations as here. I'll just show you quickly once more. So in the first one we work 2 doubles. Remember the rhythm. It's 2, 1, 2, 1. And then finishing with 2. It's 2 doubles and 1 double. 2 doubles and then 1 double. And again, 2 doubles. You need these increases to make sure that your square stays flat. And then 1 double. And then in the last stitch, 2 doubles. 2. I'm going to pop the chain 6 space to the back again. And now you're at this point, it's exactly the same as that point. I'm going to do a chain 6 and then work the double crochets along these 7 singles. Chain 6 and work along these 7. Chain 6 and then close on the first stitch with a slip stitch. So go all the way around and then I'll see you for the next round. Round 7. This round is similar in nature to round 5. I have a slip knot on my hook and we're going to start in the first of these 11 double crochets. Now it doesn't matter which one you choose. I'm going to take this one. You have to start in there with a single crochet. And the first one is a standing single. Make a single crochet on the other 11 stitches, or other 10 stitches, so you're going to have 11 in total. So that's one on each of these double crochets. So that's 3, 4, this is 10, and here the last one brings you to 11. So that's the first standing plus 10 more. We're now going to do the same we did 2 rows down. We're going to work a front post treble around this front post treble from round 5. Now remember these front post trebles, they are surprisingly easy to forget. So we're going to do a front post treble. That's twice over. Around the post, right to left, back to front. Pick up and complete the treble. Going to continue to the chain 2 space that you've got in the shell here and the chain 6 to the back. We're going to grab them both together and work a new shell. Let's yarn over. We're going to do a double crochet, so through the chain 2 space and the chain 6, having the chain 6 to the back, catch and complete the double. So you're going to do 3 of these doubles. So this is 2 and this is 3. Chain 2, 1, 2, and then 3 more doubles in this same space. So 1, 2, and 3. Now, what you're going to do next? No, not the singles, first the treble. So really remember these front post trebles. Twice over. Back to front, right to left. If you're left-handed, it is all the other way around, of course. And the treble. Now you can go onto these double crochets and work a single crochet in each of those. The first one in the first stitch, you might just slightly have to just fold your work back to really get into that first stitch. That was 1, so you're going to do 11, 2, 3, 10, and 11. And then this stitch here is again exactly the same as that stitch there. So this unit here, you're going to repeat this all the way around. And what's important, after you've done your last shell, remember this last front post treble. You're going to work there before joining with a slip stitch on your first single. This last front post treble is notoriously easy to forget. So remember that last front post treble. Go all the way around and I'll see you for round 8. Round 8, new color yarn on my hook with a slip knot, and we're going to work in the single crochets we did in the last round. So you've got 11 single crochets here, and to start in the first one, you can also start in that position or any other position, doesn't matter. And to start with a standing double crochet. In the first one, I'm going to do the first double crochet. In that first stitch. Make a second double crochet in the same stitch. So it's 2 double crochets in the first stitch. 1 double crochet on the next 2 stitches. So that's 1 and 1. Now we're going to do 2. One, two doubles. One double crochet in the next three stitches. So one, and one. Now we're going to do two double crochets. And two. Next two stitches, do one double crochet in each. So it's one and one. On your last stitch, you do two doubles. It's one and two. So now you've worked a double crochet on all the 11 singles that you had. So just to show you the rhythm here, you're thinking, how are we counting? You have the center line. You've got 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1. This is your center line. 1. So that's why you see here in the center you've got 3 double crochets. So those 3. The center and either side you've got 1. Then again, 2, 1, 1, 2. So it's symmetrical. It's 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. Center 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. You look at the rhythm. If you feel the rhythm, you can't possibly go wrong with remembering how many double crochets and which stitches. Quickly show you again. Going to do again a chain 6 because we also want to skip the shell and the trebles, just like we did 2 rows down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chain stitches, and then on the next shell, or a shell I should say, series of single crochets, 2 in the first, 1 and 1. 2 in the next, and 2, and then 1. Your center 1, and 1 on the other side of the center. 2 on the next. One, and then the last stitch, just last single crochet, 2 again. Now you're at the same point you were here. Again, chain 6, skipping this shell here, and work your next series of doubles. Chain 6, next series of doubles, chain 6, and close on your first standing double crochet. Round 9, I have a new color yarn on my hook again. In the first of my series of double crochets, I'm going to start with a standing single. And a single crochet in all the other stitches also. This is going to be 15 in total, so it's the standing plus 14. This round is again very similar to what we've done 2 rows down, with a single crochet on each of the doubles. You're going to do a front post treble, work a shell, another front post treble, and then again a single on all of the doubles. And we repeat that all the way round. So in that sense, there's a lot of rhythm in this square. And that's what really makes this square so nice, is that rhythm. A single crochet on each of the doubles. Now comes the front post treble again. Remember? Twice over. Front post treble around that treble from 2 rows down. and then complete the treble. I'm going to work a shell in the chain 2 space and catching the chain 6 that's to the back. So over both of them. So 1, 2. Oh, my yarn is just a little stuck here. Just a moment. There we go. And one more, yes, 3. 3 doubles, chain 2, and again 3 doubles. So 1, 2, 3 doubles. A treble around the treble on the other side. So again, framing that shell. Exactly the same as we've done before. And again on the double crochets, work a single on each. And these stitches here, these stitches are the same as those stitches we just made. So this repeat, do this all the way around. And after your last shell, work your last front post treble and then close with a slip stitch on your first stitch. Round 10, new color yarn on my hook, and we're again going to start in the first single crochet of any series of 15 single crochets. In the first one, start with a standing double crochet in that first single. And make a second in the same stitch. So again, 2 double crochets on the first stitch. Do 1 double and 1 double. And then next we're going to do 2. So 1 and 2. Now we're going to do 3 doubles. So 1 on each. 1, 2, 3. The next stitch, do 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. The next 3 stitches, do 1 double crochet on each. 1, 1, and 1. Next stitch, you're going to do 2, 1, 2, then 2 double crochets on the next stitches, so 1 on each, so 1, 1, and your last single, going to do 2 in there, 1. Again, just trying to look for the rhythm here so you can easily remember. The 2 double crochets here, you worked in the center in one stitch. That's the center of this piece. So you're going to do 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, that's 1, 1, 1. These two here are the center, then symmetrical on the other side, so that means 3 again, so that's 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. So again, it's 2, so it's an increase, 1, 1, an increase, then 1, 1, 1, an increase, 1, 1, 1, increase, 1, 1, increase. Now if you forget this, no problem, just follow the pattern closely. At this point you should have 19 double crochets. Now it won't surprise you, you're going to do a chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Skipping the cluster and the trebles, in your first single, do a double crochet and also a second one in that first stitch. And these two doubles are exactly the same as these first two doubles that we just made. So you're going to repeat this all the way around. After your last chain six, close on your first stitch. Round 11, again very similar to two rows down. I'm going to start with a slip knot on my hook and then make a single crochet in the first of these doubles and a single crochet on the next 19 stitches. I believe in the previous round I said you had 19 double crochets. That's not correct, you've got 20. It's a small mistake on my part. My apologies. So you're going to do a single crochet on each of these doubles. Then you're going to work a front post treble, a shell, another front post treble, and then another 20 singles. And you're going to do that all the way round. So this is very similar to what we've done before. And after this, we're going to start squaring up the pattern. 20 singles. Around the first treble, work another front post treble and complete the treble. In the chain 2 space, going to work a shell. Remember to catch the chain 6 to the back. Just got everything secure. It's 1, 2, 3. Chain 2 and 3 more doubles. 1. Going slightly faster because you have seen the essence of these stitches before. 3 doubles, so that makes your new shell. A treble, just twice over around the next treble. Remember these trebles, they are surprisingly easy to forget. You won't be the first one. And then on the double, work my first single, and again work one on every stitch. And that's going to be 20 singles again. And these stitches are of course again the same as these stitches here. So repeat this all the way around. After you've done the last treble, remember your last front post treble, close with a slip stitch on your first stitch. Round 12, I have a new color yarn on my hook. And this round is going to be a little different. You've got the first of these single crochets here. You're going to skip the first one, very important. You're going to start on the second of these single crochets. Going to start in that second stitch with a single crochet. So this round is different. So the first one we're skipping, go to the second single crochet and start with a standing single crochet. Continue and work 18 more singles. So you're going to have 19 single crochets in total. I'm going to bring you to the other side of these stretch of stitches. And then this here, that last single crochet, this is the last one. You've now worked 19 single crochets, including the first standing. Just check 19 single crochets. Remember, when in doubt, just quickly count your stitches. You've done 19 single crochets. We're now going to skip the treble, the front post treble. We're going to skip this stitch, and then on the 3 double crochets, going to work a double crochet in each of those. So skip the treble, and then work a double crochet on the 3 doubles. In the chain 2 space, work a shell. So it's 3 doubles. Chain 2. And then 3 more doubles. 1, 2, and 3. Just get more yarn, there we go. We're now going to skip the first double crochet of the shell, and actually that's making life easy for us because that first stitch it's already being hidden by these stitches. So in there, if I just pull that apart, that's the first stitch there. But you're going to skip that stitch, so don't worry about it. And the second one is the one you're going to start in. So in that second stitch, that's the center of the 3 from the shell, work a double. Also on the next, work a double. And on the treble, work a double. And this is an asymmetrical corner that you've made here. Remember here on this side we've skipped the treble. Here you work in the treble. Here we've worked in the in all 3 of the stitches of the shell. Here you've skipped the first stitch of the shell. So you've still got 6 stitches either side, but they're worked in different places. So don't worry about this asymmetry. This is to help you to tweak it everything back into shape. So take note of which stitches you're skipping. We're now again going to skip a stitch. We're going to skip that first single crochet and go to the second stitch. And work a single in there. And this single is exactly the same as the standing stitch that we started with over here. So this is the first of 19. So it's 1, 2, 3, and then continue until you're onto the last stitch, skipping the treble, etc. So that means everything we've just done, so these single crochets, skipping the treble, working these doubles, and then remember skipping a stitch here. That first single crochet, you're going to skip that first double. After the new shell, you're going to skip, and this treble here, you're going to skip. Do that all the way around and close on your first stitch with a slip stitch. Round 13, again, I need to cut a yarn on my hook. Going to start with any of the single crochet stitches. I'm going to start in the third single crochet. So it doesn't matter if you start here or on these ones or any other ones. I'm going to take the third one. That's important. You see here the first 3 stitches. So you see that's a double. That's the last double worked. 1, 2, 3. So in that third single crochet, start in there with a standing single crochet. That's your first single. Going to work 15 more. It's going to bring you to 16 single crochets. So this is 3, 4, 14, 15, 16. Now work 16 single crochets, that's including the first standing stitch. At this point you're going to have 1 single crochet left. See here? 1 single before you get to the series of doubles. That 1 single crochet, you're going to skip that stitch. On your double crochets here, you're going to work 6 doubles. Skip the single, and your first one is on that first double crochet, you're going to work a double. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's going to bring you to the chain 2 space of your previous shell. In that chain 2 space, and now really do take note, we're not going to work a shell, we're going to work a corner. It's going to be 2 doubles, 1, 2 doubles, chain 2, and 2 more doubles. So really take note here, it's very easy to go autopilot and work a shell here. You don't want to do that, you want to work a corner. Then going round the corner, so this is the first corner of your square, going to again work 6 double crochets. But again we're going to skip the first double crochet of the shell. So this is exactly the same as the previous round. So this first stitch, so that's that stitch there. You're going to skip that stitch, and then go on to the next, which is your first double. And you're going to work 6 again. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then number 6 will fall on the first single crochet. So that's a checkpoint for you. Number 6 is that first single crochet. So now you've worked 6 double crochets. Going to again skip 1 stitch. That's the next single. That's the second single, we're going to skip that. And then the third single, we're going to work a single crochet again. And this stitch is exactly the same as the stitch we started with. So this is the first of 16, so that's 1, 2, 3, etc. So everything we've just done, this corner here, going to repeat this on the other 3 edges also. After your last double crochet, you're going to skip this little, the second stitch, you're going to skip that stitch. You're going to work a double crochet in the first single crochet, skip the second single, and then close with a slip stitch on your first standing single crochet. Go all the way around, and I'll see you for row 14. Round 14, new color yarn on my hook. And we're going to start in the second of any 16 single crochets, so any group of 16, take the second single crochet. So that's the first one, go to the second, and start in there with a single crochet. And now going to work a single crochet on the next 13 also. So I'm going to do 14 in total. So that's, so this is 2 then, including that first one, that's 2. 3, 10, 11, 12, this is 13, and the last one is 14. So you have 14 single crochets, so it's a standing plus 13. Going to skip your next single. You should have 1 single crochet left here, that one there. Going to skip that stitch, skip that one, then on your double, going to work a double crochet. And that's going to be the first of 8. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and number 8 should bring you to your corner, and 8. In the chain 2 space, I'm going to make a new corner, so it's going to be 2 doubles, chain 2, and 2 more doubles, 1, and 2. Now going around the corner, going to do a double crochet on the next 8 stitches, and this time we're going to work in that first stitch also. So be mindful of that first stitch, to be the first of 8. So that's 1, 2, 3, again. So that's 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Number 8 should fall in your last double crochet. It's a checkpoint for you. Going to skip your next single crochet. So that's the first one of this series. Going to skip the first one and in the second work a single. And then this stitch is exactly the same as the stitch we started with, our standing stitch. But this is the first again of 14 singles. I've now done the first 3 with you. Going to repeat this. You can see how you've now made your corner here. Going to repeat this on your other 3 edges also. After you've worked your last 8 double crochets, close with a slip stitch on your first stitch. So that again means you're going to skip that first single crochet. Round 15, new color yarn on my hook. Round 15 is similar to round 14. Going to start in the stretch with the single crochets. Going to skip the first one and start in the second. Skipping the first single crochet, start in the second with a standing single crochet. Going to work a single crochet in the next 11 stitches also, so that's going to bring you to 12 single crochets in total. You're going to skip the last stitch and then work the doubles. You see the rhythm here is similar to round 14. So we're going to work a total of 12 single crochets. And I just dropped that one. Let's just do that again. There we go. And 2 more. Just going to count my stitches just to be sure, but this should be number 12. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yes, you've got 12 single crochets. So you've started in the second one, and you've got one left here on this side also. So you're going to skip that one single crochet, skip that last one, and in the next double, work your first double. And this is going to be the first of 10, which will bring you to the corner again. We're going to work a new corner and then work 10 doubles again. So you can see how the rhythm is similar to the previous round. So we're going to work a double crochet on every stitch. That should be 10. And 2 more. Going slightly faster here. And this is number 10. So now work 10 double crochets. In the chain 2 corner space, work a new corner. So that's 2 doubles. 1, 2 doubles, chain 2, and 2 doubles. 1, on your next edge, you're going to start with 10 double crochets. You're going to skip that first. You're not going to skip that first stitch, so be mindful that you don't accidentally miss it. So first one, I'm going to work 10. It's 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, and number 10 here should fall in your last double crochet. That should be number 10. There you go. Going to skip the next stitch. It'll be this. That's a first single crochet. You're going to skip that one. Then in your next one, that's the second, work a single in there also. And this is again going to be the first of 12 single crochets. So I've now worked 3, and these stitches are the same as these one we made here that we started with. So repeat everything we've just done, work your corner, go all the way around. After you've done your last double, skip this first single crochet and then close with a slip stitch. Round 16, I have a new color yarn on my hook. I'm going to start in the first single crochet of these, any 12 single crochet group. I'm going to start in that first one, this time with a double crochet stitch. So in that first single, work a double crochet. And this first one is of course a standing double crochet. Continue and work 11 more doubles. That means on every single crochet you're working a double crochet. And this is the last one. So on that last single crochet, work that number 12. So now I have 12 double crochets. The next 3 stitches work a half double. So 1, 2, 3 half doubles. Single crochet on the next 9. That's going to bring you to the corner. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And number 9. We're now in the corner. Your next is the chain 2 corner space. In the corner you work a single crochet, chain 2, and another single crochet in the same stitch. That's your new corner made. Turning your next edge, start with 9 single crochets, and be mindful of the first stitch here. You don't accidentally skip that first stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 single crochets. Your last 3 doubles, you've got 3 doubles left here. I'm going to work a half double on each of those. There's 3 half doubles. 1, 2, 3 half doubles. Add your single crochet stitches again and work a double on each of those. So that's going to be 12 doubles. And this first double here is exactly the same as a double that we just started with. So everything we've just done, the 12 doubles, then the 3 half doubles, the 9 singles, the corner, etc., etc. Continue that and do all the way around. And after your last half double here, close on your first stitch with a slip stitch. Round 17, the last round of this square. I have a new color yarn on my hook. At this point, it's also important to just take a look at the size of your square. Depending on what size it is, you might want to adapt your last round. I'm going to work single crochets in every stitch. If your square is slightly too small, work half doubles. If it's really too small, you might even want to work double crochets. So take a look at your size and then kind of estimate what's best for you. I'm going to work a single crochet in every stitch. I'm going to start in the first double crochet on any edge with a standing single crochet. Then continue and work a single crochet on every stitch. When you get to the corner, work a single crochet, chain 2, single crochet. and then on your next edge again work a single on every stitch. Your square is slightly smaller, replace these singles with half doubles, and if your square is really too small, work your singles with double crochets. So in essence, you're going to work a single crochet on every stitch. In your corner, in the chain 2 space, work a single, chain 2, and another single, and then repeat and work a single all the way round. When you've finished your last round, important, just work away your last yarn tails and any other yarn tails that you might still have. I'll do that in a moment. What you'll also notice is that your square is a little wonky and wobbly. It really, it does wobble a bit. So important also at this point is to block your square, because it'll help to make the shape nice and flat. And when you've blocked your square, you'll see it's nice and flat. And this is a good base for the rest of the squares that you may want to connect to it. This is the end of this instruction video. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again next time.